what our plans are tonight. We're going to be starting a series on what's going to start tonight. Thank you. Divine, right? We have to feel feeling for it. They want to divide it. We need to
conduct of how to go right forward. I've heard so many different opinions about what's going on in the Middle East. Now, read your Bible. All we have to do is get a clear understanding is read the Bible. And ask the Holy Spirit if you're reading your time to do. Don't be alone. Good idea from my Bible reading 45, 6 times. Until we get it. stand up on our parking lot and go pay for it. And I've been to this several times. If you ever get a chance to go, you need to go, because the Bible is alive like never before when you actually walk the streets and go there. Obviously, I have people guys who teach the word. I taught at a whole different, I teach at a whole different level, but preach at a whole different level by going there. So I really recommend some guys, hopefully, it talks down the way that you're so excited to go. But this park will have to be every day, the same cover, the short mark, and it's a big trip connection to God's promised land. You get a chance to go. The city of David is home with the, with what it's thought of to be King David's the pilgrims rode at the pool of Siloam, but also on the right of the cliff about Israel's ownership to the left bank that God promised Abraham and his descendants. Most often, this is not what you heard on the cliff. You hear it during churches, you hear many pastors preach about it, you don't see it. The people have been not many talking much about it, but then the pilgrims are a lot of questions about it. But it is a true story of Israel, and some of the many reasons you and I, as believers, stand with Israel, support them, and believe in the fulfillment. And they don't just believe in their fulfillment. We have to stand. We have to believe in their fulfillment, the fulfillment, and the destiny. Amen? Because this is part of our destiny. Part of this is the search land. I'm going to talk about two or three things that Christ has showed me. Now, starting to get the beginning to understand, the foundation of what's going on here. When the terrorist threat has come from, then what is the future of Israel? The United States and the nation of the world. Israel is surrounded by enemies that are bent on their destruction. The country bent on their destruction. They want to annihilate the Jewish people and take the land that God promised. They have never been able to. They're not interested. Even though people have talked about it, land for peace, you've heard that, it's just kind of thrown into land for peace, you've heard that. There's never been times that land, there's never been days to possess. They've called Israel occupied. But nothing historically, politically, or archaeologically gives them that title deed to that land at all. Just the opposite. We've got to make a stand. We've got to hold fast. So why is there still a library going on in Israel? A couple of years ago, when President Trump was in the White House, they invited my friend Larry Hunt, Jason Franklin, Trey Locke, several of them, and actually called me Trey with the president. And while they were there, they were having a discussion with everybody to kind of bring in their perspectives, their political perspectives. Everybody pretty much agreed. I agree with what was said in that discussion. But the demands of the children of God came out. I said, we don't need another piece of land. We need Israel. We need to take a stand. And everybody said, well, what can you do? What stand? Jason Alexander was funded. We know that between Lebanon, Syria, and the Golden Heights, we need to put like a statement to declare that Israel alone has sovereign rights over the Golden Heights. We have influence. What am I trying to get at? It's God, the Holy Spirit. We have influence. So we have influence. It's time to take a stand. It's not time to just sit. It's not time to just go, oh, that's sad. I'll fight for you. No, it's time to engage. It's time to get involved. Amen. I don't know where God put me in some ways. He's put me in the last couple of years, but he has. So I'm just making sure. He's walking out daily. what you know, I don't know how to tell you to follow the Lord day by day. And as he opens the door and gives us influence, we're going to take it. Amen. Because I believe that God's going to be using supernatural people to do supernatural things. We have to have people do it. We have to have obedience to do it. We have to be obedient. So we're still not a better world, but we're going to be totally logical and that's no thing. social media, videos, photos, unspeakable parties. There's some gruesome words come out of the spread, the brutality, and the callous discard for their lives. It's been happening every day. Every day. Oh, the dead weight of young women.
Thank you.
John does, is he commits a new note. Preston Wilson, in the days from Prime Minister Benjamin and Benjamin Gardner, and all the leadership of Israel. Keep that, don't be silent. Yes, I talk to you. That's the Pastor Wilson, he's been talking to you, I'm talking to you. It's not so much we know the truth. Because some of the history, I can give you even more history on. It's time for us to not shut up. You know, we've been told all the way to school to stay out and shut up. I'm not telling you, not a little, it's time to rise up and use your voice. Amen? It's time to fight like ever before. It's time to love like ever before. We're not going to be silent. We're going to share the truth about what's been happening and why. We're going to let others know that Israel has the right and the obligation to live and draw, but it is the Hamas and all the terrorist threats. Once and for all, you know what? How they do it is their business. So, war is war. War is money. War is not fun. It's not like the movies, guys. It's not a movie. This is what we'll do. So, don't get all involved in the news and what's going on. That was all programmed anyway. What the truth is happening is baloney. This is just actually the different thing. Talk to the folks in the government. Talk to the leaders like the government. Get connected with those people that know what's going on with them on the ground as we speak. Talk to the Jewish friends. You tell us in the Bible, we're friendship with many secular and religious views. They're all good people. They're all good people. But others are not friends. They're filling up a lot of trouble. They want to change God's appointed times and seasons. They're attempting to bring it on again to know somebody. They know the same those. Those who are coming against Israel will be annihilated. I'm going to kill Israel. That means they're going to kill you. They're gone. our country. We all know there's certain trouble. This is over here saying they want to kill you. You get off. You get off with America. And you're here. It's on. Let's talk to them. Ministries like this would be targeted. Are you ready? We don't fit the camp. But we don't have our tail between our legs. Beyond anything we can think right now. We give you all the praise and all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name. When I was growing up, there used to be a peace sign. Next week we're going to really dive into the message that the Holy Spirit gave me on the Holy Spirit. I'm a crippled Christian. Part one will be a crippled Christian. Let me just tell you, we're crippled. We have nothing without the Holy Spirit. I want to encourage everybody here present online as well to do more research. And here's what I mean by that. Look up this very specific letter. In the mid 1800s, there was a Freemason Illuminati elect named Albert Pike. He wrote a letter called the Letter to Mankini, M-A-T-I-N-N-I, Albert Pike, Letter to Mankini. This gives a detailed instruction on a third world war, highlighting how Palestine is going to go against Israel. Do your own research. Educate yourself. Because I guarantee you, the Western programming of our schools, we are not taught this. They kept this information from us. So, research yourself, Albert Pike, Letter to Mankini, and it'll give you a detailed instruction on how the Illuminati is going to go against Israel to cause a third world war. It's right there. Would you do that for me? Would you do that for yourself? Because you owe yourself the truth. Because the enemy has to always tell us what he's doing. And it's right there in black and white. I have told you to do your own research. I'm going to go to the next one.